الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين. Say a name. Everyone's got it right, right? You want to try someone else? الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. Say a name. الحذيفي. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. Say a name. علي جابر. Abdullah al-Matrur is similar but slower. You got it. Okay, what about this one? Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Maliki Yawm al-Din Iyaka Na'budu Wa Iyaka Nasta'in. Anyone heard that? Anyone heard that before? I see only the people in the first saf know who it was. Please, can you put up your hand at the back if you know that recitation, you recognize it. Put up your hands. Rahmatullahi alayhi, Sheikh Muhammad al-Subayl. He was an imam of Makkah in the Haram in Makkah for almost 50 years. Subhanallah. Amazing, right? What about? Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. No, come on. An imam in Makkah still called Salih ibn Humayd. Do you agree? What about Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Maliki Yawm al-Din Iyaka Na'budu Wa Iyaka Nasta'in. Anyone? Ahmad Talib, Muhammad Ayyub. The point I'm raising is, it's the same surah, it's the same Quran, it's the same words, but each one is soothing in its own way, impacting upon everyone in its own unique way. So Allah says, "Alladhina amanu wa tatma'innu qulubuhum bidhikrillah. Ala bidhikrillah tatma'innu alqulub." It is indeed the remembrance of Allah that will calm the heart of a believer. That's what calms the heart of a believer. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the calmness.